Hey guys, this is Brad from Max Rarity. I have Jared, aka Figment, here. And forgive the dog in the background. My parents' dog does not know how to be quiet.
Gotta love him.
So he is going to be doing his deck profile for he topped 128 in the Fort Wayne Regional, getting him up to 100 points now, with all that stuff he's done, for his Worlds points. So I'm going to let him deal with that.
No,
be right back.
Yeah, you're gonna get to take care of the doggo? Crazy doggo. What's up, guys? Alright, so for those of you who have actually played against me over the weekend, I actually advertised part of the channel while I was going around, but I was playing Night March, of course, my favorite expanded deck, with the exception of Vileplume, which is no longer allowed because Force Giant Plants is banned. And if you notice the list I'm playing of Night March, I'm playing Maxi's Night March, which, may I notice, no longer has Archaeops. I have this lovely guy, Machoke. Honestly, I can't see. Wait, can I tilt this? Oh, look at me. I can see what I'm doing. I can see how this is horribly off-center. There we go. I'm going to fix this. There we go. There we go. All right. So, well, there we go. This is a Machoke. Its ability is Daunting Pose. Basically, it'll block Silent Fears and Greninjas. That is one of that's the important thing. That's what it blocks. He maxes that out, along with having Gallade in the deck to make your matchup against Turbo Dark, Walk in the Park. As well, if Marshadow in the deck, you throw one of Marshadow, since personally, I tested using the Marshadow March list. However, honestly, Marshadow just doesn't work in Night March as well as people like to think it does. I feel like its main strength comes from, like, toolbox decks, which unfortunately don't see playing expanded. But hopefully we'll see some more in standard. As you've seen other videos on the channel here, we've got the Marshadow anti-meta list that you can go check out. We'll hopefully have those somewhere down in the description for you. Anyways, moving along here, we got Tauros in the list as well. That makes for your matchup against Toadbats fairly easy, when played correctly, that is. If you don't have Turn of Items, you sit here with Tauros, you Horn Attack, you let it punch you a couple times, and then you can Rage and start taking some easy knockouts. Mad Bull early game, takes out Toad, gets you really far ahead in prizes. Tapu Lele, excuse me, Tapu Lele here, Energy Drive, good attack, basically X-Ball Mewtwo, just a good attack in general, effectively replacing the Jirachi in the deck, since that, actually now you have an attack, good HP, everything else. You have Shamans, of course. Shamans, draw support, make sure you get the maximum consistency to get the maxis on every single turn. In the games where I actually needed it to win, I hit the maxis pretty much every single time because this list is bonkers consistent. But, this is the Pokemon line. Got two Shamans, one Lele, one Tauros, one Marshadow, one Machoke, one Gallade, one Orangaroo for the Instruct draw support, and combined with Gallade there, that makes you completely, end proof. So low card end at the end of the game, you don't have to worry about it at all. So we're going to move on straight over here into the supporters and the stadiums. So you got one stadium in this deck, one Dimension Valley, because your main attackers are going to be the Joltik, Gallade, Marshadow, and Tapu Lele and Tauros, depending on if you need it or not. Do you want to read the card, Brad? There you go, bud. Alright, gives you one less, so you can use Pumpkaboo. And it also makes it so Marshadow can use it. And what I found out over the weekend, Tapu Lele. So really good go with that.
So I got Tapu Cure for free, yes.
No, not for free. You still have to attach one energy, but that's nice for a lot of other decks, not Night March. So I've got three Sycamore, two Maxis Hidden Ball Trick, again for the Gallade and the Machoke. Got an AZ for easy switches into heal off damage, which I found very useful against Trevenant. So if it takes enough damage, you can just scoop up Marshadow, scoop up by Tauros, and you're good to restart that. Got one Lysander. I prefer Lysander over Guzma for a variety of reasons. I saw Lysander being 10 times more useful than Guzma in pretty much every situation, because Lysander guarantees you a switch, and you don't have to worry about having something on the float stone off the back or having to retreat. Which, depending on the deck that you're running expanded, Guzma's better. Honestly, I prefer Lysander, that's just me. Getsis. Awesome freaking card. That is possibly one of my favorite cards from the weekend. You play that against a mirror match. It was my eighth round. I ended up tying that round, but first game, played Getsis, took out his entire hand, sat there, there was nothing he could do. It was lovely. But Getsis in general, if you don't know what the card does, your opponent reveals his or her hand, and then any item cards take there, you would then shuffle back into the deck. It's very strong. I like it a lot. Then moving on here, we got 1N, of course, to shuffle your opponent's hand. It's mainly for disruption late game, since you have the Ranguru and the Gallade to ensure whatever you want to draw into. And then a Hex Maniac, of course, for the Trevenant matchup if you face that. It allows you to get a first turn. That's your Everything of Lysander. You're able to Lysander around the item lock, since it only is effective while Trevenant is in the active slot. And that goes for supporters and stadium cards. Now, moving on to the largest portion of the deck here, of course, the item cards, making this, yes, a little susceptible to item locking decks such as Toad and Quaking Punch and Trevenant. However, most times you're going to blow through all your item cards on that first turn and it won't matter. So let's go start right here. You got your 4 Ultra Balls. This guarantees you make sure every single turn you can get your hand size down to 0 for the maxis if you need to hit it on the beginning of your turn. And also allows you to go for the Shamans and Tapu Leles. Of course, then moving on here, I've got your 4 Battle Compressors. This guarantees you almost every single game you're going to draw into a Battle Compressor. And discard Lampence, Gallade, Machoke, just so you can set up the easy combo. Another card that a lot of people don't use that I really liked actually in this list was Puzzle of Time, running 4 Puzzle of Time and able to get back DCEs. Of course, with this, I do not run special charges, since I only run 4 DCEs. Of course, we'll go through the rest of that as we're going here. We've got 4 VS Seekers to ensure that you can always hit this maxi. These are your these 3 right here, VS Seeker, Battle Comp, and Ultra Balls. That can basically is the key portion of your maxi's consistency right there. So just move these off to the side here, going through the rest. We've got 2 Trainer's Mail. Had to cut a few since it's a very tight list. Once we break it down, it's a very tight list. Then you have 2 Fighting Fury Belts. Only 2 for a couple reasons. One, you could attach one to a Marshadow and ideally 190 HP. There's very few things that will hit 190 that first turn, except for a mirror match. And the mirror match, you're never going to put a Marshadow down. So that's the most important thing. Or many EXs down actually in the mirror. That's the goal. Then I have 1 Escape Rope. Escape Rope's primarily there for Jolteon. Jolteon doesn't see much play in Expanded, and that's the reason I didn't really prioritize having a lot of Switch cards. However, the Escape Rope in the mirror match was perfect for being able to set up easy knockouts on a Shaman. Got 1 Field Blower, good to get rid of Fighting Fury Belts, Stadium cards if needed, anything else around that could cause an issue. Got 1 Float Stone in the deck. Only need to attach really 1 a game because you have the AZ and the Escape Rope to provide other switching options. Mainly you're going to want to attach this to an Oranguru or if you have a Machoke out, either or is fine. Of course, your Ace Spec, most important card here, Computer Search. It's very versatile. You can use it any point in the game, almost any point in the game when you have 2 cards in your hand to discard. Late game, Instruct, if you have a Computer Search, you can get end to 1, Instruct, draw all the cards, and then have just enough so you can Computer Search. Of course, under an item lock that may not be as effective, but still a very good card nonetheless for almost every other matchup. Then, of course, the 1 Choice Band in the list. Now, Choice Band was mainly there just to get the pretty numbers on easy knockouts on things such as...
Card of 4.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Brad. 10, with only 10 Night Marchers, Choice Band just blows right through it. It's perfect. And that's actually one of the matchups I had against Kevin Baxter in round 4. We were both 3-0-1 at the time. I had a 2-0 victory against Card of War because you're able to just hit such high numbers so quickly with the deck. And, of course... To end it, you have your 4 double colorless energies. Very, just your basic list of Night March. Of course, that is how I went through. Going through my day, I finished 5-2-2 and top 128 at Fort Wayne. First round, I faced Waterbox, went 2-1, started off 1-0 against that. Round 2, I faced against Turbo Darkrai, went 2-0 against that. Round 3, I tied against Raifu Eels, a good friend of mine, Jeffrey Saran. Then round 4, Guard of War, 2-0 against Kevin Baxter. Round 5, I faced up against my first Trevenant matchup of the day. I did not win that game, however, that's one of the coin flip matchups. Trevenant is very close still. It's not as lopsided as people tend to imagine. I'll just fumble through the deck here as I'm going through the rest of these. Then I went 1-2 against that Trevenant. Round 6, I faced yet another Trevenant deck and beat that 2-1. Putting me up at the time, I believe that is 5-1-1. or no, 4-1-1, and I faced Drop a Garb round 7, went to 2-0 against that. The Marshadow, of course, being the key in that matchup, being able to score some very heavy, quick knockouts against the Drapa without having to discard many energies, or Pokemon, for Night March. Then round 8, I faced my Night March mirror. That was my first mirror of the day. I ended up tying against that. That was a very good game. The guy I played against, he played a one of Oricorio. Oricorio was my downfall this tournament, of course. I started that from that. I was 5-1-2 going into the final round. I needed to win to guarantee my spot to top 64. Unfortunately, at the time, I did not win that matchup. I faced against a Drompa Garb with 2 Oricorios in it and multiple rescue stretchers. So, of course, for those of you who don't know what Oricorio does, Revelation Dance does 1 damage counter for each Pokemon in your discard pile. So, with Night Marchers, of course, your goal is to discard a lot of Night Marchers to be able to hit heavy numbers of damage. So, even when I was playing conservatively, he was still able to spread 7-8 damage counters by the second or third turn just to start taking easy knockouts on Night Marchers. If I had one way to improve that matchup, all I can say is play more conservatively and focus more on Tauros and other attackers in the deck. And I think that just about wraps it up.
So I have a question for you.
What's that question?
So, obviously, Marshadow is pretty good.
Love Marshadow. It's a nice card.
What do you think of a Night March combo with the baby evolutions, the 3, the Espeon, the Jolteon, and the Glaceon.
Oh, and expanded with all that?
With then 2 rainbow energy.
So, only thing with that is I could say, I feel like that's something that we could do in another topic deck discussion. But if I had to do a short input on it now, I would say the problem is there's just too much switching and the environment and expanded. It's 10 times more fast-paced than it is in standard. That's a good standard deck, though. Gonna go check out one of our other videos on that.
Yep. Okay. Well, thanks for watching, guys. Share, like, subscribe. You know that jazz. Sorry about the dog in the background, however. He's I don't know what else to say. He's just here. And may your life be as maxed as my decks. You have a great day.